You now have a quorum, Mr. President.
Thank you. We'd like to welcome you once again to the New Mexico State Senate. We'd ask that each of you please rise for the invocation to be led today by the Reverend Gail Lindsay Marriner of the Unitarian Universalist Church here in Santa Fe. We'd also ask that you remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance to be led by Senator Tallman, the Pledge of Allegiance in Spanish to be led by Senator Gould, and the salute to the New Mexico flag to be led by Senator O'Neill.
Actually, I'm going to invite you to sit down for a moment because I'm going to tell a story before we actually do the invocation. And I will invite you to rise again when it is time for the invocation. This is a parable, a contemporary parable, from a book by Sandy Eisenberg Sasso from the Jewish tradition. Once, there was a community that had no windows and no roads. The people lived in houses that were sealed up tight like boxes wrapped in brown paper. No light came in, and no one could see out. Because there were no roads, it was very hard to move between one house and the next, and people stumbled through the tall weeds and fell into large holes and tripped over rocks. The people in the community did not like this. They didn't want to live this way. And one day, when they were all out sneezing in the tall weeds, they decided they really could use some help sorting out this problem. And someone had heard of something called God. Now, what God was, a he, a she, an it, they weren't sure, and some of them weren't sure that God even existed, but they had heard that God would help people solve problems. And so they decided that someone should go looking for God so that God could fix their community. Now, at the edge of the town, there were two houses that were different from the rest because they each had a single window. And the villagers called the ones who lived in the houses, the old man and the old woman who could see out windows. And they decided that if anyone could find God, it was the ones who could see out windows. And so they asked them if they would go and look. And the old man and the old woman said yes, they would see what they could find. As they made their way through the tall weeds away from the village, a group of children followed them. And so it was that two small groups set out to look for God. The old man and his companions looked high and low, but they found nothing. The old woman and her companions looked far and wide, but they found nothing. Finally, they came back together and compared notes and told stories about the oceans and the mountains and the people they'd discovered. They agreed that while there might be a God out there, they didn't know where to find it, and they went home. Now, the villagers were very upset that no miraculous help was forthcoming. But life went on as usual. Except the old man and the old woman and the children who had followed them, they decided they would put more windows in each other's houses. They decided they would take the stones between their houses and fill in the large holes and cut down the weeds. And finally, they got to the point where they built a path all the way down to the heart of the village, to the square. And the villagers were startled. "Wait a minute. I thought you said you didn't find God. How is it you are doing these things?" And the ones who could see out windows smiled and said, "Well, we didn't find God. We found each other. And when we found each other, we discovered God was already with us." "What? God is with us whenever we gather together." "Where?" said the people. "Right here," said the old man and the old woman. "Here, among us, between us, in the between, between us." And so I would invite you this morning, my friends, to consider what is between us as we gather in this place. In the story, there is an invisible presence, present when the ones who see out windows listen to one another and help one another. I know that you have experienced this invisible presence. I have. It's the thing the Hebrew Bible calls the still small voice, the presence that speaks after the storm. It's the spirit that the Christian Bible identifies as present when two or three are gathered in Christ's name. It's the energy or the field or the chemistry. It's the something more that emerges from a group or a congregation or a legislative body when they are listening to each other and working together over time. And you cannot see it, and you cannot touch it, and it has many different names. This morning I want to call it soul. And I want to suggest that the Senate has a soul, that there is a presence or an energy or a field that emerges from your interactions with one another, from your experiences and your memories, and that that soul has its own integrity and its own identity and its own coherence over time. Quaker author Parker Palmer writes about individual souls as elusive. Church consultant Susan Beaumont says the same is true of our community souls, that you have to sit quietly and listen for them, that they disappear in busyness and in schedules. Certainly, as you go into the last week of the session, your lives are very full, and your calendars have very few empty spaces. This is a very long preamble to what will be a very brief meditation, an invitation in the midst of the storm and the fury of these last days to be present to the spirit that moves through these halls and to listen for the soul of this august body. Would you rise, please? I invite you to close your eyes if that is comfortable for you and to take a deep breath. To open your hearts and your minds to the mystery that moves between us and among us here. Emerging spirit, gathered wisdom, long memory of ancestors, presence of abiding love. Be with the senators gathered here. Be with their staff members, and with the lobbyists and the activists. Be with all who gather in this space in service to our larger community. Move between us and through us. Guide our words and actions, that every decision made by this body may be wise and generous in support of the health and well-being of all who dwell in this beautiful state. May it be so. Shalom, blessed be, namaste, assalamu alaikum, ashe, aho, amen.